Hi, today I would like to introduce the most recent version of the MPS PA Compact Workstation. The MPS PA Compact Workstation is a compact learning solution for teaching process automation regarding the different process variable, pressure, flow, level, temperature. And that system can be used to learn about the fundamentals. So I will explain you the different components that we can find in the system. And at the end, I will explain you the different configuration that we can have, the different options that we can have in the learning system. At Festo Didactic, we offer a complete portfolio of learning solutions in process automation. You can start with introducing students with the basic concept of process automation using the Didactic PA. So you, with the Didactic PA, you would cover how to measure a sensor, what is a pump. And if you want to go further to the next step, you go with the MPS PA Compact Learning Solution. And if you want to have process automation application, you can select the MPS PA 204, which is a system that includes four different types of station. We offer the filtration station, the mixing station, the reactor station, and the bottling station. You can choose to work with the initial standalone learning solution for each application, or you can combine the station all together. And if you want to cover initial instrumentation and with initial component for the valves, you can work with we offer a complete portfolio of initial learning solution. So as we can see here, we have three different tanks. We have the main tank here at the bottom, we have the upper tank here, and we also have a third tank, a pressure tank, where we will create pressure to measure and control pressure. So with the system, we need to have different sensors. So we need to measure flow, we need a flow sensor. So we have a magnetic flow meter here, and this sensor measures the flow rate going through the pipe. And we use a centrifugal pump, a small centrifugal pump, to circulate the water inside the system and to increase the flow rate and increase the pressure in the system. For measuring temperature, we need to have a temperature sensor. We have a temperature sensor here on the bottom tank. And for measuring the pressure, we have a pressure sensor here. This one measures the pressure inside the pipe and inside the pressure tank. The level measurement is done in the upper tank. So here we can see an ultrasonic level sensor. And we use that level sensor to measure the level of the water here, and that measurement is sent to a controller, a PLC or a software. So if we want to change the flow rate, as I mentioned, we use a centrifugal pump. To increase the pressure, we use a centrifugal pump. But it is possible to control the flow rate, not only by changing the speed of the pump, but also using a proportional valve, this one here. To increase the temperature in the system, we have a heater here in the bottom, the tank at the bottom. And that heater, we send, it is a proportional heater. We can send a signal to make the heater working from 0% to 100% to heat up the water. So we measure the temperature using the sensor. We heat up the water with that heater. But we need to cool down the water. So what comes with the main system is a water air cooler. So it is a radiator with two fans, and this radiator will bring down the temperature of the water. In option, it is also possible to use a chiller. So we offer as an option a small chiller here with more cooling capacities, so you can cool down your water more quickly. So we have a different option for the controller. So with this system here, you can see a S1500 PLC from Siemens with a touch panel. And the touch panel can be used to monitor the different parameters as the student would do in real life in the industry. And it can be used to adjust the parameter in the system and to control the system. So it is very convenient. But we also, with the basic system, we also offer a software, a great software, Fluid Lab PA. And that software uses the easy port, the interface here, to communicate with the different sensor and to send the signal from the system to the software, Fluid Lab PA, and Fluid Lab PA will send back the signal to increase the speed of the pump, increase the power of the heater, to do process control. So we have a different configuration that we offer. There's a basic system, so like this one here, but it is possible to have the basic system covering pressure, flow, level, temperature, and using only the software, Fluid Lab PA with the easy port. And there's also another configuration with a Siemens PLC. So with the Siemens PLC control package, you would also get the Fluid Lab PA software because the didactic features of the software are really great. So you need to have both to have a complete system. We also offer Allen Bradley PLC with a touch panel from Allen Bradley and Festo PLC with a touch screen. The configuration that I just presented to you is a basic system configuration. So if you want to cover more industrial instrumentation, it is possible to choose the system covering process instrumentation. So with the process instrumentation, you would get an industrial temperature transmitter, you would get an industrial magnetic flow meter instead of a commercial one like this, and also other instrument measuring the level inside that tank. It is also possible, if you want to study energy management, to select the energy management option. And with the energy management, you would cover how much energy is used by the pump. And you would be able to monitor that to see what is the impact of if I change the speed, if I change pressure inside the system, what is the impact on the power consumption. With the basic learning system that I've just presented you, we use Fluid Lab PA. But it is also possible to use Fluid Lab PA multiple control loops. So with that version of Fluid Lab PA, you would be able to cover not only PID control, but also cascade control. So a cascade control loop with a level and a level control loop and a flow control loop. So it is interesting for the student to learn more than just the PID process control. The MPS PA learning system comes with a complete curriculum. So we have a user guide where the student learn more about each component. So and where they learn inside using the user manual, they learn about how to configure, how to adjust the different components. It's kind of a reference manual. We also have a student workbook. So with the student workbook, a student do many kind of different experiment, project-based experiment. They learn about troubleshooting. They learn how to measure the process variable for pressure, flow, level, and temperature, and how to adjust the controller, the PID parameter of the controller. So all the curriculum is available on Festo LX, and you can use Festo LX to go through all the curriculum. I presented you the MPS PA Compact Workstation. And with the workstation, you notice that there's a magnetic flow meter. And that magnetic flow meter uses IO-Link communication protocol. So it is also possible to work with your students about how we configure a magnetic flow meter using IO-Link communication protocol. We also offer with the MPS PA Compact IoT add-on. So the IoT add-on would introduce the student to the Internet of Things for process automation. So it is a very valuable add-on to the system, and it is something that would interest the student. Now I will present you what we can see on the touch panel. So the touch panel permits to change different parameters. So for pressure, flow level, we can and temperature, and we can work in manual operating mode or in automatic mode using the controller, the Siemens PLC controller. So this is the main screen of the touch panel. So the operator panel can be used to control the level, the flow, the pressure, the temperature. We can work also in manual operation. So we'll start with that mode. Manual operation. Here, as we can see the different components. We have the pump, we have the proportional valve, we have the two tanks with the sensors, the water inside the tanks, and we also have the heater here. So as we can see, we have seen the pump pumping at 50% and the flow rate going up to 2 liters per minute. And it is also possible to heat up the water in that tank in manual mode. We can activate the heater by pressing that button here. And now we see it's blinking red and we see the green light on the heater. So now the heater is warming up slowly. Now, if we go back to the control mode, we can have access to the level in the tank, in the upper tank. When we have access to the flow rate here and to the temperature. So we should see the temperature going up slowly. We can do a flow control loop using the flow screen here. So if we go there to the flow control loop, we go to the PID, and it is possible to enter the three different parameters for the PID, the proportional band, integral time, and the derivative time. And so if we want to see the piping and instrumentation diagram, we can press there. We see the configuration of the system. We can also have access to the trend recorder, so we can monitor what is going on in the system. So I can change my set point, and I can increase the set point. Let's say we go up to 30%. And now we see the pump starting up, and we see that it has difficulty to maintain the flow rate because the PID parameters are not right. So it is possible to adjust the PID parameter to make the flow rate smoother. So we can go there and decrease the gain. And then we'll do another set point change. Let's go to 50%. And we see that now the process is smoother. And it's more the integral action which takes place instead of the gain. I can stop everything by pressing stop. And I can do the same thing with the level and the pressure and the temperature. I just presented you the MPS PA Compact Workstation. If you have any question, you can contact your local sales representative or contact our service team at Festo Didactic. Thank you.